Hello again, everybody, and welcome to our weekly interview on WWE.com. My guest this week, former WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Daniel Bryan. Welcome.
Thank you very much.
I cannot tell you how excited I was to see you come down the aisle on Raw this past Monday night. You were running the show because the authority was put out of power at Survivor Series. What did it feel like to be able to go in the ring and really stick it to Stephanie and Triple H?
Oh my gosh, unbelievable. I mean, they've been persecuting me and the rest of the WWE roster since SummerSlam last year. I mean, it's been, as a performer, sometimes that's brutal because you're working so hard and you're seeing yourself progress and you're like, okay, I'm getting close, and then constantly having the rug pulled out from under you. I mean, that's a brutal feeling. So it was fun to go out there. It's always fun for me to go out there in front of the crowd. I mean, gosh, I've missed that. That's like, it's just this burning thing in your heart, and it's just, you know, it's just right there. But then to be able to, and just rub it in their face, you know, like something, we don't get a chance to do that very much. Like these big corporate people in power and just say, no, you know what, you're not the boss of me anymore.
What were you thinking about? I'm sure you're watching Survivor Series at home, and what was going through your mind when you saw Dolph Ziggler down 3-1, and then he started to eliminate one guy and then another guy, and it looked like he was going to win the thing? What was going through your mind?
I was just rooting for him. There is something, you know, there's a bond that you have with certain performers because you relate to what they're going through. I relate very heavily to what Dolph Ziggler goes through. He is one of the best performers in WWE, and he goes out there and works his heart out every single night and goes out there and steals the show, like he says, almost every single night. And you root for people like that who are underdogs, who are facing three men, all of whom are bigger than him, and keeps pulling it out. And so I was there, or I wasn't there, I was watching it and just thinking, come on, Dolph, you can do it. You can do it. And he did it.
What about when the man called Sting showed up in a WWE ring for the very first time?
Oh my gosh. Okay. I have been a wrestling fan for a very long time. Like, I love wrestling. And it's this weird crossing of worlds where Sting is in the WWE, in a WWE ring. And it just gets you excited. Like, it's something that everybody can feel. You can feel it through the screen. Like, I'm sure the people in the arena, it was an unbelievable feeling to be there live. But when something emotes through the screen to somebody, and I've seen a lot of wrestling, and when things emote to me through the screen, you know it's special because it's emoting to people all over the world. Everybody could feel that emotion and feel how special it was. It was awesome.
We're not done with you yet because Friday night on SmackDown, we understand you're going to be running the show again. What do you have in store for us?
I don't want to spoil all my little surprises. I like to keep a few things in my sleeve. But I will let everybody know that there's going to be a big Intercontinental title match with Luke Harper and a man who truly deserves it, Dolph Ziggler.
Awesome. That's going to be great. Finally, you've been out of action for a while with an injury. WWE fans are clamoring for an update on your condition.
Well, things are going really well right now. I mean, I'm feeling good. It's not actually a feel issue. It's recovering the strength in my right arm because it's a nerve issue with my neck. Long story. Nerves affect strength, whatever. So I'm in the process of trying to get that strength back. When I'll be back, I don't know, unfortunately.
So you can't give us any little timetable?
I wish I could. I wish I could tell you I'd be back on Monday. I wish I could tell you I'm going to be there for the Royal Rumble. I wish and pray that I would be able to tell you right now that I'd be there for WrestleMania because I went to Levi's Stadium for the on-sale party, and that place is going to be magic. It's going to be awesome. But I can't do that. There is no timetable for my return right now.
But you didn't say you wouldn't be there.
I didn't say I wouldn't be there.
Daniel, thank you for joining us. You and Bree have a great Thanksgiving. Enjoy yourselves, and we'll see you Friday night.
All right, thank you very much.